In this tutorial, I'll show you how to change the inner glow color of a glass material. Let's create a cube, scale it, and remove three faces in edit mode to create a background mesh. Type 2 to edge select. Shift select three edges and bevel them by using Ctrl B, shortcut with mouse wheel, up, to add more segments. Right-click to shade smooth. Let's create a UV sphere. Ctrl 1 to subdivide, and right-click to shade smooth. In edit mode, type 3 to face select. Let's select the top faces. Shift D to duplicate, and type P to separate by selection. We need to select the duplicated mesh and extrude it upward in edit mode. Let's deactivate the subsurf modifier. If we just select the inner part, the mesh won't look good. It's best to select the whole thing and scale it a bit. Type 1 to vertex select. Type S, Z, and 0 to align them on the Z axis. Let's remove the selected faces. The next part is the most important part of this tutorial. That is how to work with the 3D cursor and the mesh's origin. Let's Alt-select this edge loop, and press Shift-S to move the 3D cursor there. Let's add a mirror modifier. Nothing's working, because we haven't moved the origin to the 3D cursor yet. We could mirror this sphere, or just move it on the Z axis manually like this. I'll remove the subsurf modifier for this mesh. Please apply all the modifiers before joining the meshes. Shift select and Ctrl J to join them. To move the 3D cursor back to the original world center location, press Shift and C together. Now we can duplicate and rotate the mesh like this. This is how the mesh was created. The glass material looks like this. I'll show you how the glass material's inner glow color change node works. We can change the inner glow color like this easily. This is the background material. I have used cycles with 128 samples to render the scene. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.